Little, let's kick it off in this meeting, all right? So, Puckett, I told you when we were working on this meeting, all right? This is the first meeting you ever did with everybody, right?
That's right.
Part of your development, though, right?
That's right.
Part of your development is coming up here. Cody Williams, you put together a hell of a meeting last week. Part of your development is getting up here and addressing the entire team, training, coaching, all right? You gain respect when you coach people in the room. So, very excited for Puckett. We started with a purpose and outcome. Every meeting you do, Russ, in the future, you need to always establish a purpose and an outcome. Correct, Josh?
Right.
I learned that from the man himself. So the purpose of this meeting, all right, we're resetting expectations to perform at a high level, all right? We've been what the past 2 years?
Franchise of the year.
Franchise of the year, right? So without further ado, we've been waiting for this for a long time. So give him a drum roll, everybody.
Tim B.
Mr. Tim Puck.
Who here remembers the old shop rules?
The 10 jack names?
No, the consolidation teams. Not too many people. Consolidation teams, we had a trifecta team, we had a metal team, and we had a consolidation team. Now, consolidation is good, it could be better. We're getting lazy a little bit. Parking lot, it's garbage. There's still screws, there's glass everywhere. So with this team, we start holding our team accountable. Ops should not be out in the trucks doing consolidation. They're not our babysitters. We are leaders. We got seniors out there, we got crew leaders, potential crew leaders, and some people are just staying around. So that stuff needs to stop. So Jose and Jason May became up with the team. And that's effective Wednesday morning. When you guys get here. It's not daycare. Be prepared to work when you show up. The teams, they switch every month, so there's no 3 month rotation, no quarterly rotation. So everybody will be outside in the snow and rain, and vice versa. Along with the consolidation team, the trifecta team has a tough job. They have to do every Tuesday truck inspections, something that we have not been doing lately. Trucks been going down. They've been in shops, out of shops, hurting our jobs, because we need trucks. And why is consolidation important to us? Does anybody know?
To create empties.
Derek?
One, to create empties in space, and the other, to reduce dump costs and extra costs associated with taking things to transfer stations. So making sure the trucks are full and an adequate weight to take them to the dump in order to facilitate lowering costs for the company.
Most of us have jobs right at 8 o'clock. The more empties we get, the faster we get there and start making our money. The next thing I want to talk about is consolidation. How many people go to hot tubs that's on a deck that they can't roll off, so they have to cut it up, and there's no Sawzalls available? Has that happened to anybody? It's happened to me a few times. Trevor, Adam, Lawrence. We're doing a checklist. So, if you need a Sawzall, if you need shoulder straps, if you need a moving blanket, because every truck at one point had a moving blanket, now they're all gone. Josh, how much are moving blankets?
$15 a piece.
That's a lot of money. 17 trucks times that price, and now they're all gone. So we're doing a sign-out sheet. If you take a Sawzall, it is up to you to turn it back in. Start being held accountable for it. It's not fair to everyone else who needs these tools. Piggybacking off after consolidation. When you're in the trucks, take care of your office. That's our office that Tyler is leasing to us. How many times do you guys go to a job site and there's trash falling out of it in front of a customer? Has that happened to me before? It's a little embarrassing when there's hot dog containers coming out onto their driveway. Sometimes we forget about it. We don't see it up in the truck. So taking care of office happens throughout the day. If you are with a senior or a crew leader, those leaders are to help you guys clean up your trucks or enforce clean up your trucks before you go home, because the trucks are stinking like crap. Leftover food. There are still dip cups in the trucks every single day. We had this talk numerous times.
They're nice and warm.
Oh, yeah.
But guess what, Jeremy? we go to a damn transfer station. Pretty much every truck goes to a transfer station every single day, right, Tyler? So if we have a bag of trash in there, what's probably the best place to throw that bag out?
In the transfer station.
Out the window.
Out the window at the transfer
station. It takes 20 seconds.
That and you have a giant trash.
I don't even think it takes 20 seconds, bud. No. Right?
If it's not in a bag, 20 seconds.
Well, just what you were saying right there. It's just it's as easy as when you stop at Quick Trip, just asking for a bag, setting up your bag, and all your trash just goes in the bag, and then you can just pitch it out the window, opposed to I've got something here, I've got something here, I've got something here. It's not hard to just grab a bag at Quick Trip.
If we're hired to go and help somebody clean their house, Cody P, and we show up and our office inside of our truck's not clean, what kind of impression does that give the person? And these guys might not do a very good job because they can't clean up their own stuff. Get over to my job. Right, JD?
Yes, sir.
Every week we talk about aggressive driving. Every week. Sometimes it goes in one ear and out the other ear. So, enough's enough. This is going to happen. How many people have Snapchat? How many people have Facebook? How many people in their personal cars text and drive? Okay. And these trucks are 12,000 pounds. If you hit somebody, you're doing some serious damage.
You kill somebody.
Easily. Hydroplane if you don't pay attention in the wintertime or fall time, springtime. So there's going to be some rules for aggressive driving. Because I know all you guys, you work hard. You guys, when you get that call, hey guys, last job, bring him back. You guys are excited. You guys want to get here quick. I want to get here quick. But we have a convoy rule for a reason. We don't want to race people, because that's embarrassing. We're not supposed to be racing people. We're not supposed to be excessing the speed limit.
Also, there should be no excuses. So it shouldn't be to the point, hey, I was pulling up alongside of him to let him know that we were going to be getting off two exits ahead of us or something like that. We all know the convoy rule. So make sure we follow that. And everything can be perceived differently. So regardless of whether you're in the right or you're in the wrong, if you're not doing what you were expected to do, we're going to automatically consider you wrong, okay? So just keep that in mind, okay?
But I care about my job, guys.
Yeah,
it's embarrassing when customers have to call in, your junk truck's out racing side by side, even if you guys are only going 6 miles an hour and speed limit 65. It's embarrassing. We should not be doing this.
If we're going 40 miles an hour, you got one the other day with Jalen, are you right? You got one the other day pulling up next to each other for whatever reason, all right? We could be going 40, 45 miles per hour. If somebody on the highway sees two junk trucks going 40, 45 miles per hour right next to each other, it gives the impression of what?
They're racing,
right? I mean, you could be going, however slow it is, but just the fact that they're driving next to each other, kind of alerts somebody to pay a little more attention to them. If we get a little wild, we do start racing or whatever the case may be, it's happened before. I mean, it cannot happen. All right, fellas, we've got to practice convoy driving. The great thing is, on Culture Up this morning, I'm going to be putting a video that me, Jason, and Derek made, and it shows you how to properly do convoy driving. hey, we're setting these expectations today because we haven't talked about it. And a guy like Jeremy that comes in, maybe you haven't heard these expectations. A guy that's been here in a short period of time, Jamie, maybe you haven't heard these expectations. So we need to always set the expectations before we go out and hold each other accountable. Does that make sense? So hence the purpose of this meeting. Now, we've got a lot of tremendous leaders in the room, and we expect you guys to hold each other accountable. All right? If you are holding somebody accountable for doing the right thing, I'm going to side with you every single time. So Puck, what else you got?
Last but not least, what do you guys consider this group right here? I consider this a family.
Heck yeah.
And over the past few months, it doesn't seem like a family to me. Everybody's after everybody. Trash talking. If you underbid a job, I underbid a lot of jobs. So it's up to your teammate to help you make it right. Either go back and talk to the customer, or that teammate will say, okay, this is what you did wrong, let me go and fix it. So you can watch how this person works. The trash talking, saying people are golden childs around here. That's not true. There's no such thing as a goddamn only child. Just because someone gets big jobs every week, everybody gets a big job every single day. You might start off with SIP jobs. Ops makes it right and gives you a layup, either a truck or plus. So the shit talking's gotta stop. Because you're only putting yourself down and your teammate when they have to hear it. And it's not getting anywhere. If you have a problem, bring it up with ops. If you have a problem with that person, work with them. See how they get these big jobs, see why they get these big jobs, and how they make so much money doing it. If we can stop that, the brother will be even better, we'll make even more money, and we'll be more positive. And then more money means more parties.
I think, hold on one second before we give him a tremendous round of applause. I think it's if we got a new guy that comes in. Jeremy, you've been here how many days?
This will be my third day on the trip.
Third day, right? It's all of our jobs to make sure Jeremy becomes the best trucker in the class. Okay? A lot of times I get feedback from guys and everything like that. I don't think this guy's doing well. Okay, well, what did you do to help him get better today? Oh, well, you know, I just had to watch me and everything I do. No, you got to help somebody out. You got to coach them up. You got to teach them. Jordan, if you're riding around with Adam, right? Adam's been here a lot longer. He's got you outranked and everything like that. Do you think Jordan's going to feel comfortable about saying, hey, Adam, you underbid that job, man. You couldn't have been out without that. Right? It's just natural. That's how it is. So how do you open that up for Jordan to provide you some feedback?
If there's anybody new that's ever worked with me, I always ask them, how did I do on that bid? How did I always need an outside opinion, and how I did, because I stopped hearing it, because, you know, as soon as you, I have a month in the business, people don't care anymore, so ask.
That's a great point. I know a lot of the senior crew leaders in here, you know, during this time of year, you know, Cody, maybe you're not working with Tim Puckett, or maybe you're not working with a Trevor Stewart or another senior crew leader every single day, you know, you're training a lot of new guys and everything like that. That's unfair to a guy like Cody or a guy, senior crew leader like JD, because they're not getting that type of feedback that they deserve on a daily basis. JD, you could definitely provide some feedback to Cody if you guys are running around in the truck together, right? And vice versa, right? So Jordan, so you got Luke, Jordan, all you guys, offer that feedback to them. We're talking about setting expectations, holding people accountable, getting better every single day. And it's gotta come from Jeremy. If you notice me doing something out there, I will have that conversation with, hey man, I thought you could have did this better when you initially brought me in on the walkthrough and everything like that. Right? I don't get better if a guy like Puckett doesn't come in and say, hey, you know, I think your leadership can improve. Oh, you know what? I damn sure made somebody more than the wig yesterday when I showed up at 701, based off the conversation we had last week, right? That's me resetting my expectations to make sure we're running a finely tuned third fucking year in a row franchise of the year. So, I appreciate it, Puckett, for you getting together, putting that stuff together. I think it's a tremendous thing. We're laying it out for you guys. Let's make this place better every single day. First, improving leadership. Know everybody in here has a voice, right? Now it's all about how you approach the person in that situation. You know, you don't want to come in, hey, fucking dumbass, man. You should have did stuff this way, right? There's always a better way to approach it, right? You want to approach somebody respectfully. Say, hey, man, next time you get in that situation, why don't you try this? I saw that it worked for me because I had the same struggles you have in that situation. But tremendous job strengthening leadership, obviously holding each other accountable, and that's how we grow, and that's how we get to the fucking next level. So give it up for Puckett.